विद्वद्श्रेष्ठ रामकृष्ण भट्ट महोदय एतस्य संस्थानस्य न्यासी परमेश्वर भट्ट महोदय पद्मकुमार महोदय सभायां उपस्थिताः भगिन्यः भ्रातरः अहम् अधिकतया संस्कृते वदामि मध्ये मध्ये इंग्लिश वाक्यं योजयामि मिश्रणं करोमि सर्वे अपि भवन्तः सर्वे संस्कृत अनुरागी जनाः संस्कृत प्रेम अस्ति संस्कृत प्रीति अस्ति संस्कृत विषये अभिमानः अस्ति अतः संस्कृतं पठन्ति संस्कृतं इति एका भाषा अस्ति भाषायाः अभ्यासः कथं करणीयः भाषा ध्वनि प्रधाना लिपि ही स्क्रिप्ट अनंतरम प्रथमं ध्वनि ही प्रथमं श्रवणम अनंतरम भाषणम सो श्रुत्वा श्रुत्वा उक्त्वा उक्त्वा अभ्यासः करणीयः संस्कृत अभ्यासः अपि भाषण माध्यमेन करणीयः अस्तु प्रथमं एकं विषयं वदामि संस्कृतं किमर्थम् इति इदानीं एतत् भवनम् अस्ति अत्र रात्रिः यदा भवति दीपः ज्वालनीयः सो दीपः ज्वालनीयः इति भवान् गत्वा स्विच् पिञ्ज नोदनं करोति दीपः न ज्वलति द्वितीय पिञ्ज नोदनं करोति दीपः न ज्वलति तृतीय पिञ्ज थर्ड स्विच् नोदनं करोति दीपः न ज्वलति यु ट्राई ऑल द स्विचेस पुटिंग ऑन दीपः न ज्वलति किमर्थम् एक मेन स्विच् अन्यत्र अस्ति तत् मेन स्विच् ऑफ अस्ति प्रथमं मेन स्विच् ऑन करोतु चालयतु तदा एव दीपः ज्वलति तथैव भारतीय जीवनस्य एक प्रकाशः अस्ति आत्मप्रकाशः इति वदति भारतीय जीवनस्य सारः सः एसेन्स् आत्मदीपज्वालनाय संस्कृतम् इति एक मेन स्विच् आन् करणीयम् तर्हि एव ज्ञानदीपप्रकाशनं भवति ज्ञानदीपशब्दं भवन्तः जानन्ति सो एवं बहूनि उदाहरणानि सन्ति सर्वे वेदान्तम् इच्छन्ति भगवद्गीताम् इच्छन्ति यु ट्राई टू लर्न वेदान्त यु लाइक वेदान्त पीपल गिव लेक्चर ऑन वेदान्त ट्राई टू स्प्रेड वेदान्त बट यू डोंट learn the language of Vedanta. You don't teach the language of Vedanta. Bhagavad Gita avashyaki. Parantu Bhagavad Gita yah Gita bhasha na pathati. Yoga avashyakah. Parantu yogasya bhasha na avashyaki. Vedah avashyakah. Vedasya bhasha. Ayurvedah avashyakah. Ayurvedasya bhasha. So how would you get master on all those subjects? If you don't learn the language of Vedanta, how would you master Vedanta? So that is what happening for last 100, 200 years. That is why we are still not able to understand Vedanta, not able to understand Gita. You read the translation of Gita 100 times, you will not be able to appreciate it. Because after all, you read translation, not the Gita, because you don't know the language of Gita. That is why, since language is the only media to connect us with our heritage, and we don't know that language, hence we are disconnected from our heritage. So learning Sanskrit is connecting ourselves to our heritage. Evam mukhya vishayah asti. Sanskrita literature, Sanskrita vangmayam, apara jnana bhandaram, jnana sagara. You take any branch of knowledge, name any branch of knowledge, you have some texts on that branch of knowledge in Sanskrit literature. Hindu Swayam Sevaka Sangha Dwara outside eka exhibition sthapitamasti. Karyakrama anantaram kripaya pashyatu. Sanskrita vangmaye kim kim asti. Architecture bhavatu, arithmetic bhavatu, life science bhavatu, engineering bhavatu, vastu shilpa, athava arts madhye sangeetam athava yatkimapi. Sarvasya vishaye Sanskrita literature madhye asti. You know, manuscript iti, you know, how many of you have seen any form of manuscript? Raise your hands. Okay, how many of you have seen the photo of manuscript? There are, you know, old palm leaf manuscript, paper manuscripts, various types of manuscripts are. Some 12 or 13 forms of ancient manuscripts are available in India. Of course, outside India also. And according to the National Manuscript Mission of Government of India, there are 4.5 million manuscripts in organized sector. There are 4,800 collections in India, public and private collections of manuscripts, where 4.5 million manuscripts are lying. 0.5 million manuscripts are taken outside India. And according to the government of India, there are still 5 million manuscripts lying idle at villages. There is an organization called INTAC in Lucknow who made a survey in 300 villages of 3 districts of Orissa. So after 3 months survey in 300 villages, they were able to identify 47,000 manuscripts in villages. Only Sharada Puja Samaye manuscript, they are bundled, kept. Sharada Navaratra Samaye, Sharada Utsava Samaye manuscript bundle Udgatayati, Pujam Kuruti, again Bandhanam Krutva Stapayati. That is all. National Manuscript Mission made a survey in eastern Uttar Pradesh and northern Bihar, 1,200 villages, 6 months survey. After 6 months survey in 1,200 villages, they found 0.72 million manuscripts. 0.72 million manuscripts in villages. And Puratanani Kitaha Khadanti Nashtambhavati Ityadi Ityadi. And they are written in 14 scripts. Various scripts. Scholarship is declining. Samskruta scholarship. Samskruta scholarship iti yada aham vadami. Samskruta vidwan, Samskruta pandita. You know, shastras, Vyakarana shastra, Nyaya shastra, Vedanta shastra, Mimamsa shastra, like that. Shat darshana shastra, Shat nastika darshana shastra, Bahu, Sankhya, Yoga, evam binna binna shastrani santi. Ekaika shastre bahu granthaha bhavanti. Hundreds of volumes of texts and their commentaries. In ancient days, the examination system of Bharat was different, not of today's. It was called Shalaka Pariksha. Shalaka is needle. You know, student is supposed to master the whole text by three ways. One, he has to memorize the whole text. It may go to 500 to 700 to 1000 leaves. In those days, there were leaves. That is just pages. The whole text has to be memorized. Then he should be able to explain, comment on, vyakhyan. Third, he should be shanka samadhan. That is, wherever question is asked, he should be able to answer. That is called shalaka pariksha. Maybe Ramakrishna, bhavan shalaka pariksham svikrutavan? Vedante, uttirna, kati pariksha, sampurnam? Chatu siddhi pariksha. You know, even still, I will come to that. You know, still, Sringeri Sannidhanam, Mahasannidhanam, they are trying to keep it alive, revive that tradition of examination. Now, I will just explain how the examination is taken. When the student is ready with that particular grantha, then in ancient Gurukulas, he offers to take examination. Then the whole that Vidyalaya, all Acharya students, they assemble in the hall. Three examiners Acharyas will sit on the dais, and the student also will sit near the Vyasapitam, and the text is kept there. The whole staff and other students of the whole Vidyapita, maybe a few hundred or a few thousand students, will assemble. In everyone's presence, the first acharya, the examination is conducted in three rounds. The text is kept on the Vyasapitam. The first acharya, you know, if the needle is of this kind, the first acharya inserts the needle in the text anywhere he wants, and leaves the
needle there. The student has to open it, see the first line, close the book. From that first line onwards, he has to tell the text of the book by memory until the satisfaction of the first teacher, Acharya. Till he says stop, still he says stop, he has to continue. Then the second Acharya will insert the needle, Shalaka. Then from there, he has to continue saying. Then the third Acharya inserts. That is the first round is over. Second round again, Acharya Shalakam Stapayeti, Chatraha Udghatayeti. Then he has to Vyakhyan, comment on, he has to explain the meaning and also give references of various Acharyas, what they have said. Like that, three rounds of test. Third round, after the needle, insertion of the needle, text is opened, the context is set, then the Acharya will ask question on that particular context. He has to answer. So three rounds. Tenth round, question from audience. Whoever, whatever can ask on that text. And he has to satisfy. If the student is passed on all 10 questions, 10 needles, then only he is passed. If he is failed in one shalaka, anuttirna. So, eka, pratyeka shastre, minimum 14 granthas are, minimum 14 to 20 granthas are prescribed. Perhaps he has taken 5-6 examinations. Bharat, that is called Tenali Pariksha. 14 examinations in each Shastra. 4, 5, 2, 3. He has completed 3 examinations. There are many such scholars who have completed 14 examinations in one Shastra. Still there are a few scholars who have completed, you know, have you heard Dvishastra Pandita, Trishastra Pandita, Chatushastra Pandita? One who has completed 4 examinations in 4 Shastras, he is Chatushastra Pandita. One who has completed in all 6 Shastras, Shatshastra Pandita. Today, we have only one person, Divya Purusha, who is Shatshastra Pandita, Manya Paramapujya Swamiji. He is Shatshastra Pandita, only one person. There is one Chatushastra Pandita, Rama, Dr. Ramanuja Tatacharya. He is 92 years old, who lives in Bangalore. And we have 3 Shastra Panditas, I think there are 2 persons, one in Chennai, one in Pune, who are Panditas in 3 Shastras. That is all. 3-4 people may be there. Adikahana. So, aham etadartham etat sarvam uktavan, you know, Prachina kale scholarship ityukte kidrusham asit adhyayanam jnana jnanasya vikasaha. So parantu adhya tat manuscript visheya muktavan kila, you know, there are not many scholars who can open the manuscript bundle and say to which Shastra that manuscript belongs to. Even to identify the subject of that manuscript, you need scholarship. We do not have that many people. And many scripts are also not known. There are 0.75 million manuscripts on Kashmir Shaivism. They are written in Sharada script. Today, even not even 8 to 10 people are there who can read Sharada script. Forget about editing 7.5 lakh manuscripts. Editing is a far away, distant reality. So, evam jnanam asti, tatra knowledge asti. Tasya prapti vishaye, retrieval of knowledge. Saha mahan vishaya asti. Yadi vayam, if we are able to decode those shastras, tarihi, there could be a knowledge explosion. So, samskritam kimartham, in the context of today's knowledge society, the context of knowledge-driven globe, we need samskrut. Anya samaya apekshaya idanim adhika avashyakata asti. Samskrita bhasha kevalam janaha chintayanti jyotishyasya bhasha, ayurvedasya bhasha, puja bhasha, satyam puja yaga bhasha, ayurvedasya bhasha, jyotishyasya bhasha, ganitasya bhasha, vijnanasya bhasha. See, if any of you have read a book called Beautiful Tree, written by Professor Dharmapal, beautiful name of the book is Beautiful Tree. Professor Dharmapal gives the full description of education in India in 18th century. English education system aarambha purva kale Bharate kidrusha shiksha vyavastha asit. He gives, quoting British gazetteers, Professor Dharmapal gives the whole statistics of schools in India at that time. He gives district wise numbers. In Tanjavur district alone there were 3200 schools. In Kumbakonam there were 2800 schools, all Ekopadhyaya Shala, one teacher schools in villages. Altogether 182,000 schools in India in 18th century. And what were the topics taught, subjects taught in those schools? Itadeva. All secular education, medical science, engineering, shabdaha bhinnaha tavateva. Today engineering iti shabda prayoga asti, at that time stapatya shastram tavateva, shilpa shastram namata deva. Adya medical science iti vadati, tada vaidyakiya iti asit. Shabdaha sa beda tavadeva. Sarvavida pataha asit. Take any branch of knowledge. Sanskrute. Swataha vayam vadamaha. You may be a doctor, an engineer, or a advocate, or a architect. Enrich your branch of knowledge from Sanskrit literature. Enrich your knowledge from Sanskrit literature. Sadhyamasti. So, samskruta bhasha jnanartham punaha atma vikasaya nayakatva lakshanaya. Idanim samskruta bharati, since 1981, spearheading this Speak Sanskrit movement, popularizing Sanskrit language through conversation, teaching Sanskrit through easy methods, karyam karoti.
किमर्थम कनाडा देशे अपि संस्कृत भारती अस्ति किमर्थम अस्माकं मिशन किम यदि इफ यू आस्क मी व्हाट इज अवर मिशन अहम वदामि अस्माकं यत् यंगर जनरेशन अस्ति अत्र किड्स सन्ति छात्राः बालाः इन नेक्स्ट 20-30 इयर्स दीज पीपल शुड लीड द होल वर्ल्ड अस्माकं किड्स शुड लीड द वर्ल्ड हाउ संस्कृत ज्ञान आधारेण केवलं संस्कृतम् अहं न वदामि आधुनिक विद्या प्लस प्राचीन भारतीय विद्या प्राचीन आधुनिक पूर्व पश्चिम ज्ञान संयोगेन नव निर्माण करणीय नव समाज निर्माण करणीय प्रकृतम विश्वस्य इदानीं करंट कॉइन एतत् किं सस्टेनेबिलिटी सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट इत्यादि इत्यादि सस्टेनेबल इत्यस्य भारतीय भाषा शब्दः कः सस्टेनेबल धारणक्षम भारतीय भाषायां संस्कृत शब्द ऑब्वियसली धारणक्षम सस्टेनेबल धर्म इत्यस्य अर्थ कः धर्म धर्म द रूट ऑफ वर्ड धर्म इज धृ धारणे धारणम टू होल्ड टू सस्टेन धर्म दैट विच सस्टेन्स धर्म अर्थ काम मोक्ष इति चार पुरुषार्थ जानन्ति एक्चुअली मोक्ष इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ त्रिवर्ग धर्म अर्थ काम टुगेदर दे आर कॉल्ड त्रिवर्ग मोक्ष इज ओनली द रिजल्ट ऑफ दीज थ्री मोक्ष डुएबल न करणीयम न करणीयम धर्म अर्थ काम त्रिवर्ग तरही धर्म अर्थ काम सिग्निफिकेंस किम अर्थ भवन्तः जानन्ति वित्तम संपत् काम मीन्स उपभोग एंजॉयिंग धर्म आधारेण अर्थ काम भवेत् तावदेव धर्म आधारेण अर्थ काम धर्म आधारित व्यवस्था समाज रचना धर्म इदानीं निग्लेक्टेड अस्ति पुनः अहं वदामि सामान्यतः जनानां चिंतनम् अस्ति धर्म इत्युक्ते पूजा धर्म इत्युक्ते संध्यावंदनम धर्म इत्युक्ते भजनम धार्मिक पुरुष यदि एकः तिलक धारणं करोति धार्मिक पुरुषः रुद्राक्षी मालां धरति धार्मिक पुरुषः न सः अर्थः नास्ति धारणात् धर्म इत्याहुः धारणं कस्य धारणं मम धारणं मम कुटुंबस्य धारणं न मानवतायाः धारणं विश्वस्य धारणं प्रकृत्याः धारणं ब्रह्माण्डस्य धारणं तदर्थं मम आचरणं यत् आवश्यकं तत् सः व्यवहारः धर्मः यदि अहं केवलं मम निमित्तं मम कुटुंब निमित्तं जीवनं करोमि तर्हि धर्मः इति न भवति
भर्तृहरि सुभाषितम् अस्ति आहार निद्रा भय मैथुनंच आहार निद्रा भयम् मैथुनम् सामान्यमेतत् पशुभिर् नराणाम् सामान्यम् पशूनाम् नराणाम् सामान्यम् धर्मो हि एकः विशेषः नराणाम् मनुष्याणाम् पशुभ्यः एकः एव विशेषः. Four things are common to all animals and human beings. That ahara, nidra, bhaya and maithuna. But only speciality of manava is dharma. Saha dharmaha kaha. Samanya vyavahare pashyatu. I have something eatable. And there are four or five people. Then, bhakshana arambhat purvam, kim vadati, aham ekah eva khadami, I don't give to others. Is that a dharma? Na. Dharma kim vadati, prathamam, anyesham, give to others, then you eat. Tat dharma. Aham एकः एव खादामि एषः धर्मः न सर्वेषां कृते ददाति सः धर्मः. तर्हि स्वनिमित्तं केवलं स्वार्थं यदि चिन्तयति देयर इज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन मी एंड पशु एनिमल. परार्थम अपि यदि चिन्तयामि सर्वेषां तर्हि धर्मः भवति. हा मन्दिरे पूजा करणेन भगवतः नमस्कार करणेन ध्यानेन जपेन चित्तशुद्धिः भवति चित्तं पवित्रं भवति शरीरं पवित्रं भवति धर्म आचरणस्य योग्यता संपादिता भवति. एतदपि आवश्यकं परन्तु केवलं एतत् न पर्याप्तम्. परोपकार पुण्याय अन्येषां सेवया पुण्यं भवति. केवलं भगवतः नमस्कारं करोति चेत् पुण्यं न भवति. भगवतः नमस्कारेण चित्तशुद्धिः भवति चित्तं पवित्रं भवति शुद्धं भवति. तेन धर्म आचरणस्य धर्म आचरणं नाम सर्वेषां सुखार्थं जीवनम्. तर्हि धर्म आधारित नव समाज रचना करणीय अस्माभिः. इदानीं प्रकृत समाज जीवनं स्वार्थ आधारितम् अस्ति. अहं मम सुखं बहु संकुचित जीवनमस्ति. स्वार्थतः परार्थं प्रति अस्माकं विकासः भवेत्. एतादृश जीवनं भारतीय जीवन आदर्शः भारतीय जीवन परंपरा एषा. संस्कृत माध्यमेन धर्म आधारित अर्थव्यवस्था धर्म आधारित उपभोग व्यवस्था धर्म आधारित विकास व्यवस्था धर्म आधारित नव जगत रचना करणीय. तदेव संस्कृत भारती कार्यम्. संस्कृत भाषा माध्यमेन ज्ञानं प्राप्नोतु. संस्कृत भाषा माध्यमेन स्व विकासं प्राप्नोतु. संस्कृत भाषा माध्यमेन यथा इदानीं अहं कतिचन उदाहरणानि वदामि. भगवद्गीतां सर्वे पठन्ति परन्तु भगवद्गीता अनुसारं अस्माकं जीवनं भवति वा? भगवद्गीतायां एकः मुख्य अंशः अथवा वेदान्तं सर्वे पठन्ति परंतु वेदांत अनुसारम जीवनम भवति वा, वेदांतस्य सारांशः कः, इच्छा न्यूना करणीया, वी हैव टू रिड्यूस द डिजायर, डिजायर न्यूनम 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 करोत। कैन एनी वन ऑफ अस से हाउ मच माय डिजायर हैज बिकम कम डाउन? किम प्रयोजनम वेदांत पठन? संस्कृत पठनेन यदि अस्माकं जीवने परिवर्तनम आगच्छति तर्हि उत्तमं भवति। सो एवं संस्कृत भारती चिंतनम अस्ति। सो यदि बाल्यकालतः वयम् अस्माकं बालानां संस्कृत शिक्षणं कुर्मः तर्हि बुद्धि विकासः अपि भवति, आत्मसंस्कारः भवति, भारतीय जीवन दर्शनस्य परिचयः भवति। तदर्थं संस्कृतं पठनीयम् इति अस्माकं विचारः। सो बिफोर कन्क्लूडिंग माय स्पीच आई विल कन्क्लूड आफ्टर ए वाइल, बिफोर कन्क्लूजन नो आई वुड लाइक टू हैव सम इंस्टेड ऑफ वन वे ट्रैफिक I would like to have two-way kinchit sambhashanam. Now I welcome questions from you. Yes. Just give your introduction, parichay and. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Stop it. Oh, it is recording. Ataha.
Respectfully, I won't ask this question.
Sure.
First thing is, you know, like we all have come here to know, you know, why we need to learn Sanskrit or, you know, what is the use or whatever it is. So far, you have been just talking in Sanskrit, you know, or probably, you know, you've been using a little bit of English. So, you know, we are lost. You know, I don't think 80% of the crowd got what you are saying. Let me be honest with you.
Okay. I will tell you. I'll brief you again. But before that, you know, my purpose of speaking in Sanskrit, I will answer your this one also. I will say the gist of my talk also. But before that, now the purpose of speaking in Sanskrit is to make you understand Sanskrit. Now it's I give you one example. It was some 30 years back. I wanted to meet a particular person in Karnataka. But I came to know that he was in Hariharapura near Shringeri. He was in a camp, children's camp. So from Bangalore I went there. So then I met him. So when I reached there, it was his lecture time, evening 4 to 5. He was supposed to give a lecture talk. Having me gone there, that elderly person asked me to narrate a story for 45 minutes in Sanskrit for those children. And of course, some elders, 50, 60 elders were also assembled. Then for 45 minutes, I told a story of Jorawara Singha and Pateha Simha, which those children never heard. They, most of them were from village area. And those children did not know Sanskrit also. But for 45 minutes, I spoke, narrated the story in Sanskrit. Then after it was over, that elderly person, Krishnappa, he asked the students whether they understood the story. They said, yes, we understood. Then he asked them to tell that story. He asked, how many of you heard this story before? No one knew. Then each student stood up and said the same story one by sentence by sentence for 20 minutes. The program was over. When the elders, 50, 60 elders, after the program, they went to Krishnappaji, all of them. You see, these children understood. We did not understand. Why? Krishnappaji said, you know, children with that jijnyasa, with that open mind, with the kutuhala, they were listening with that quest, longing. They were able to grasp. But what elders did, I don't know Sanskrit. Just they closed the door. It doesn't enter. Sometimes this happens. I'm not saying about your this one. Here it may be the case different because you might never had the exposure to listen to Sanskrit. I agree. Maybe people have different background. Sometimes some people had no exposure to listen to. So the gist of my talk was that Sanskrit is a great treasure of knowledge. If we are able to learn Sanskrit, then we can access the primary sources. Now, you have to depend on secondary source. You read the translation of Gita. You do not read the Gita. You read the translation of Vedanta. You do not read the Vedanta. So, translation is translation. So, one. So, it is a every branch of today's knowledge is available in Sanskrit also, not to this extent, but to some extent. You can enrich your branch of knowledge from Sanskrit literature. So, more than that, our younger generation, if they are given, if they are imparted with the Sanskrit language skills, they can have the advantage of knowing both modern and ancient streams of knowledge. They will be the blend of both East and West, so that in next 20-30 years they can lead, guide the whole world. That should be our mission. So, this is the essence. Any other question? Yeah.
One of the reasons for coming here was to get in heads up. Like, you only hear all these many years that you should learn Sanskrit, you should learn Sanskrit. But it sounds, for a layman like me, it sounds so enormous. It looks so huge. What could be the...
None? What was the question in the end?
It sounds very enormous, the whole thing, you know. So I was just wondering is it possible to simplify it, or is it, what should be the early steps in this direction?
So it need not be simplified. There are simple forms of language structures. You start with that simple Sanskrit, not simplified Sanskrit. You start with the minimum vocabulary, you start with the minimum structures, then you get to know the language. If any one of you know any one language of Bharat, then you know 50% of Sanskrit. You know, the sentence structure, underlying structure of all Indian languages is Sanskrit structure. Sound system is same. 60% to 70% of the vocabulary of all Indian languages except Tamil. But even Tamil also has got a large number of Sanskrit words. So most of the vocabulary is Sanskrit. So start with that. Samanyataha, if you spend 1 or 2 hours a week for the group study and every day 15 minutes to 30 minutes time, by 1 or 2 years you will be able to get good command over the language. So once you acquire that minimum knowledge of Sanskrit, then from there you can proceed to Shastra, Kavya, etc., etc. Did I answer your question? Okay. Atra Dr. Shambhu Upadhyaya asti, Buffalo tah agatvan, Buffalo Vishwavidyalaya Computer Science madhye pradhyapaka. I think it is only 5 or 6 years you have been learning Sanskrit, not more than that. 5 years. You know, just 5 years back, he attended he came to Stroudsburg, Jahnavi camp somewhere in New Jersey. Then weekly classes, he is attending. Now he is a teacher. He conducts Sanskrit classes also. He teaches Sanskrit. He is in advanced level. So, just I am giving you an example.
Answered. You did mention that if he follows the structure and method, in 2 years he would be at advanced level. But I guess a lot of us people in today's fast-food world, they would rather want something instant. So I guess it would be interesting if I've heard about 10-day Shibiram. So maybe people who want something immediately to begin with, not to reach the advanced level, of course, they would eventually go there. But I guess a lot of people would be interested to know about something quick method of it and how it becomes easy, if you could please share.
Bharate vayam kurmaha, 2 hours a day, 10 days class. Dashadina anantaram bhavan samskrute sambhashanam kartum shaknoti. Dainandina vyavaharasya samskrute shikshanam bhavati. Here it can be a weekend class. So 2-3 days class, morning to evening. So tatha 2-3 courses yadi karoti, sambhashana samarthyam bhavati. Then we have correspondence course also, 2 years course. After 2 years you will be able to read and understand, appreciate Ramayana Mahabharata in Sanskrit. So tadrusha pathyakrama api asti, kartum api shakyate.
After this event, we are planning to have a follow-up Bhasha Varga, which is a weekend event. It'll be 2 days, probably 3 days on the long weekend in July, July 1st. So at that point, we will have the information available that you're looking for. Sanskritena Patamaha, Sarve Pyagachantu. And you can, at that point, you will see for yourself how easy it is to start from zero, as we all did. Karyakartas all started from zero. We just studied, and we came to Bhasha Vargas, like the one we're going to hold. So please just come and see how that is, and you'll see for yourself how easy it is. We'll have all materials that you see outside available. We'll teach for 3 days, and you'll experience that. So as soon as this is over, please give your name and address or email outside at the bookstall. so we can contact you about when that Basha Varga is, but we're hoping it's going to be at the end of June. Dhanyavada.
Shastriji, within India, has Samskrita Bharati been able to implement Sanskrit learning in the schools, in the typical education system? You know, like Samskrita Bharati and so on, they are doing good job here, but this is not within the regular curriculum.
Yeah. Sanskrit is being taught in schools all over India, except Pondicherry, Tamil Nadu, Manipur and Nagaland, except those four states. All over India, about 30 million students study Sanskrit from 2nd standard to 12th standard. Other than that, it is at school level. In higher education, about 8,000 degree colleges offer Sanskrit as one of the optional subjects at graduation. That is BA, BCom, BSc, etc. And 120 general universities have Sanskrit PG departments. And there are 415 Sanskrit universities all over India. And in traditional Pathashala, traditional learning, there are about 5,000 traditional Sanskrit Pathashalas where Sanskrit is taught in the traditional way. And there are about 1,000 Veda Pathashalas. They are the places of Sanskrit learning. As far as schools are concerned, you know, in various states, Sanskrit learning starts from different level. Maybe from 2nd, from 11th, 6th, 8th, etc. This year, due to the efforts of Sanskrit Bharati, Kerala government now, from this academic year, has agreed to introduce Sanskrit from 1st standard. That is one of the Sanskrit Bharati's efforts. And Central Board of Secondary Education has introduced Sanskrit communicative approach in Sanskrit teaching. It is our effort. You know, otherwise, Sanskrit is taught through grammar translation approach. Sanskrit is taught through grammar or through translation, which is a foreign method. It is a 2000 years old European method. That method came in Sanskrit teaching during British period. Before British period, Sanskrit was taught through Sanskrit. Now, once again, we are spearheading a movement